Welcome back to another episode of Rock Boys Football. Today we are going to be talking about the 2022 Senior Bowl. The game just finished up this afternoon, and I'm going to be just giving you some of my thoughts and observations from not just the game, but the practice all week. Some say that the practice and the 1v1s and how players are talking to coaches matters a lot more than the game, and I'm just going to give you kind of what I saw and what my takes are. Appreciate you guys rocking with the Rock Boys. Starting off with the quarterbacks, this was a big week for the quarterbacks. I think six of the top seven guys were down here, Matt Corral really being the only big QB prospect who wasn't down there. And there wasn't anything that exciting. Malik Willis obviously flashed the arm talent and the athleticism in the game that you see on tape. I mean, there's no question that this guy will be an elite athlete at the NFL level. The questions are how he processes the game. Can he keep the ball out of harm's way? And can he be consistent with passes? Scott, again, has the arm talent. Was a little inconsistent from what I saw in the game, but definitely flashed some athleticism too. Sam Howell, also not that consistent. I mean, he really wasn't given much help from the offensive line. The defensive line dominated the game. They dominated the week of practice. Sam Howell did show just an absolute brutal stiff arm on Boye Mafe, just put him in the dirt and threw the ball away, which was impressive. But you saw that physicality on his film. Bailey Zappe, I heard he was in practice, just the arm talent isn't there. He has great accuracy and great touch. I mean, you don't put up those numbers he did in college without that. That being said, he doesn't have the live arm that a Sam Howell, that a Carson Strong, that a Malik Willis had. Kenny Pickett, obviously the hand size measurements are a question. That being said, I heard he put a solid week together. Same with Desmond Ridder, who I think was the best quarterback in the game. Again, these guys didn't get much reps. They got maybe two or three drives tops. Carson Strong, he was probably the worst. I mean, he really missed the throw that he had. Romeo Dubs, his wide receiver at Nevada, probably for a touchdown, he underthrows him and ends up being an interception. So you'd like to see him have that throw back. Again, these quarterbacks, like, I'm not huge on this quarterback class. I think if a team likes a quarterback, go up and get him. That being said, like, these guys aren't worth top 10 picks like we've seen in the past. Running backs, Abram Smith, he showed out. I have him in my notes. He caught a swing pass for a touchdown. I mean, everything you saw in his Baylor film. He runs like a linebacker. He obviously is a converted linebacker, and he got a lot of touches because of injuries to his team. And so him and Rashad White were carrying the load. Brian Robinson was just average. I mean, he didn't really have that many carries, and he wasn't that impressive with them. Damian Pierce stood out to me. He is a low center. He's rising up my board. He's a low center of gravity at 5'9", but 220. I mean, he's yoked up, runs downhill and hard. I like his game a lot. Devontae Price didn't play, but I heard he was pretty good in the passing drills. Jerome Ford didn't play either, but I heard he also looked good in the drills during the week. Rashad White, who I heard was not great in the week of practice, I thought ran the ball pretty well. He also gets downhill and probably has the best burst out of this class. Some say he should transition to receiver. I don't agree with that. I think he runs the ball well. He's good with the ball in his hands. And a guy you want to maybe fill out that frame a little bit more. 6 foot, 210, maybe could be up around 220. Tyler Batty did not play in the game, didn't hear much of him. Zaquandre White as well, did not hear much of him, did not play in the game. Alec Pierce had a bad week. I didn't see much of his reps, but from what I saw, bad week. Stock probably went down. Bo Melton, he's exciting. He's got some wiggle with the ball in his hands. He had a few opportunities. I don't know his complete stats. Ended up having two catches for 18 yards. But both those reps were short passes where he showed a little yard after the catch potential. He'll be a late day three pick if he gets picked. He also fielded a punt legit in the end zone, which was interesting to see. Braylon Sanders, I don't believe, played in the game. Average week of practice. I didn't hear much from him. Calvin Austin was turning some heads. I saw a few 1v1s on him during the week. He is very hard to stick with. Obviously, a little bit concerned with the frame. 5'7", 173. Not the biggest dude in the world, but we've seen guys make it work. He's fast. He's very twitchy. Intriguing prospect to keep your eye on. Christian Watson turned the most heads during the week of practice. 6'4", 211. I heard he was running some pretty polished routes. Obviously, he has some big hands, some big arms. a good guy down the field in those intermediate throws. He didn't get any burn or any work targets. He got one target where he drew a pass interference, which was cool because the guys in the box, Daniel Jeremiah, told the guy on the field, hey, go up and talk to the play caller and give him a shot, and they dialed one up for him. Danny Gray, I heard, ran the fastest registered miles per hour during the week, did not play in the game. Drummond, quiet during the game. I know he played. I don't think he got any catches. Drummond's a guy I liked him. So I'm excited for the process that he's going to go through here. Jalen Tolbert was another winner. He got a little bit of work, I think 3 or 4 catches. Again, they struggled to pass the ball, 2 catches for 24 yards. They struggled to pass the ball just because the D-line is so much better than the offense. He's a guy who can burn really fast and good at the catch point. Khalil Shakir had a good week of practice, did not play in the game. Romeo Dubs, not so good of a week of practice, but he had a decent game. I think he had a couple targets, and I don't see him on the stat sheet. So he had 2 catches for 18 yards. So, I mean, it was tough sled in the passing game. And so he probably did not help his stock too much. Trey Turner did not help his stock. Valus Jones played, didn't get that much. He had 4 catches for 53 yards. So outside of Ferguson, was the most productive wide receiver. Well, I guess the most productive wide receiver, Trace, tight end. Charlie Kohler, I don't love him. I think he's a tight end too. Obviously, big radius, big catch radius with 34.5-inch arms, 6'6". Can't really separate, doesn't really give you that much juice outside of probably red zone. Cole Turner hurt himself. I heard he did not block well, which I'm not surprised. 6'6", 246. I mean, this dude does not have a big lower half at all. I don't think he helped himself much. Connor Hayward, I heard good things. I heard he's more than just a fullback. Dude played running back at Michigan State, then put on a ton of weight, kind of played that H-back. They gave him a fullback belly that got blown dead, but it was going to work. Late round special teamer probably. Daniel Bellinger, quiet week, didn't hear much. Grant Calatera, quiet weeking. And Greg Dulcich, I heard, held his own in the blocking. Obviously, converted wide receiver, you want to see how he does blocking. I heard he held his own. I like this dude a lot. I think the size and speed at 250, he runs well. I think he's going to be a good guy in the tight end. He's my third tight end on the board right now. Isaiah Likely, I have not liked what I saw on film from him. I feel like he's just not physical enough. He gets rerouted a lot. Quiet week, I don't know if he hauled in any catches. Yeah, doesn't look like he's in the box score at all, so didn't haul any catches. Ferguson is one of the more – he's just a solid tight end, blocks well, catches well over the middle. He's going to be a solid tight end pick for anyone. And then Jeremiah Hall to round out that group. Actually, I take that back. There's a couple more guys. Jeremiah Hall, he's more of an H-back, fullback too. I heard he did not block as well, so that's a little bit concerning with the limited athleticism he brings. Jeremy Rucker, inline blocker. I don't think he caught any balls. At least I don't remember. Did not. Again, he's more of an inline blocker, probably another tight end too. And then Trey McBride, tight end one in the class. This guy will be a tight end one in the league. I like him. He blocks well. He catches well. Really all around solid tight end. Looking at the linemen, the interior guys, Cole Strange, I heard, just struggled in the one-on-ones. He had a few errant snaps as well. He gets a little overmatched the physicality is a little overmatched. So that's a little bit of a concern. Dylan Parnum, a guy that scouts like, with 6'2" and decent 33-inch arms, plays with good leverage. I think he's a day 3 pick. At Ingram and Justin Schaefer had 2 quiet weeks. I didn't hear much bad or good. Lectus Smith, I don't think played much. I just didn't really hear anything from him. I don't think he played in the game. Luke Fortner, same with his teammate Drake Jackson from last year. I think he's just going to struggle physically, how he can hold up with some of those bigger guys up front. Travis Jones ran him back into the quarterback a few times in the 1v1s. Marquise Hayes, I think guys will give him a crack. He's got really long arms. He's got a strong punch. Struggles in space, as you might think, with 6'4", 318 frame. And then Zion Johnson, probably the winner on the interior guys. He's just solid. I mean, he's going to be a day 2 pick, maybe squeaks into a late day 1. You're getting a blue chip guy, probably the biggest blue chip on the positions. Abe Lucas apparently cleaned it up. He's a really raw prospect, 6'6", 322. with long arms. Good reps. He probably raised his stock. Stuber definitely didn't help his stock. He's probably day three undrafted free agent level. Struggled with the physicality, which is a concern. They played him on the interior a lot, and he seemed to struggle with people getting into him a little bit. So not great out of him. Bernie Ryman, probably one of the more exciting prospects down there. Converted tight end, highest PFF grade as a tackle. He looked good in the game. And then the one-on-ones and the drills in practice were apparently up and down. I saw some good reps out of him. I saw some not so good reps out of him. I think he has a chance to be like a late day one, early day two pick if a team likes him. But I feel like he might need a little bit more polishing up. Braxton Jones, quiet. Cade Mays did not have a good week from what I heard. Chris Ball was quiet. Daniel Falele, another intriguing prospect. I think he's just too big. The first round mocks have to chill. Like, this dude, you just don't know how he's going to do against some of the twitchier speed edge guys. And I just don't think he plays with a low enough pad level to play him inside. So I'm a little concerned with him. Darren Kennard showed he could play right tackle, which is probably his main goal. I still think he's an interior guy, but if you want to get the money, got to play tackle. And he showed he can hang with the right tackles. Jamari Salyer looks like he's going to be on the interior. That's how we have him mocked and projected. But he was good. He was one of the winners of the week. Jatari Carter from Southern, quiet. Didn't hear much good things out of him. And then Luke Gadecki wasn't great. This kid from North Dakota, I haven't watched any film on him, but 6'6", 310, 35-inch arms. He looked solid in the one-on-ones. Look solid in the game. I'm guessing he'll get a day three pick and probably make a team. Max Mitchell was up and down, not great. Looks like he's just got to fill out that 6'5 frame a little bit more. He's a good athlete, but like 299 at 6'5, like you just got to fill out a little bit. I think he struggled with a little bit of the physicality of the power five guys. And then Nick Zakel, I think is how you say his name, just not going to get picked. Not good. Spencer Bierford was really not good. And then Trevor Penning was like getting in fights after every single rep. Definitely still like you have some concerns, but 6'6", 330 pounds, 35-inch arms. He's got some power. He's got some nasty in him. I'm guessing a team will like him. Probably early day two pick, maybe late day one if a team likes him. Big comps to Spencer, big Spencer Brown vibes from his own teammate at UNI. Interior D-line, Devontae Wyatt, I don't think played in the game, but was very, very good in the one-on-ones. I think he might have played. I don't have him on my note sheet, but he was really good in the one-on-ones. I heard he made himself some money during the week. Eric Johnson was solid from Missouri State, heard some good things. I mean, I heard some good things on all these D-linemen. Like, apparently they were just dogging the offense pretty much all week. Haskell Garrett, or Logan Hall had a good week. I don't mean to skip over him. Haskell Garrett. He is what he is, 6'1", 300 pound, one tech where I think he's just going to take on double teams. He's got a good first step, good technically produced at Ohio State, but I don't see him being like any sort of monster. John Ridgeway had a good week. He got hurt, so hope he's all right. Neil Farrell, I don't think played in the game. Nothing big out of him. Heard some good things about the UCLA kid. Definitely guy to keep your eye on. Travis Jones made some money. Both these guys, Travis Jones is just super powerful, man. I mean, if you had any concerns of like the physicality translating to like big time power five football, he was dogging a lot of SEC guys. He's good. He's really good. Perrin Winfrey was probably the best guy the whole week from any position. DT1, I think he showed like the ability to get penetration, to get after the passer. Really long arms, really violent hands. I love this dude. And then Mathis, I think, just confirmed day two pick. He's solid. Not a day one guy, but he's good. Edge guys. Mari Barno, not a good game. Not a good game, and he was not good in practice from what I've heard. Arnold Abadike, he's rising up boards. I love him. He uses his hands really well. He's a good football player. Super disruptive in both the run and pass game. I think he's going to get into the day one. I really do. He's good. Boy Mafe did not have a great practice, but he was a wrecker in the game. I think he was benefiting off some weaker matchups going against that tackle from Southern, going against Buford from UTSA. So not some of the best tackles there, but he was good. He was really, really good. Cameron Thomas got hurt day one. Unfortunate. I like the prospect though still. D'Angelo Malone showed some freaky athleticism. He's playing in space really well. Definitely a stand-up outside linebacker, but I like his game. Dominic Robinson, big-time project, converted quarterback. He is twitched up, though, really twitched up. Interesting guy to keep your eye on. Isaiah Thomas, they kept playing him in the interior. They did that at Oklahoma, too. He's definitely an edge guy. He's powerful. He's got a good bull IQ. This guy's a solid prospect, late day two, early day three. Jermaine Johnson made some money. He's got some crazy length, 35-inch arms almost, 34 and a half. Tape's good. He was good on the one-on-ones. He didn't play in the game, but, man, this dude's a freak. I have him in the top 15 on the big board. He's really good. Jesse Luketta was very good in the game. Didn't hear much about practice with the one-on-ones, but he was good. Kingsley Enagbare won the measurements. 35-inch arms is crazy. Quiet week. I think he flashes like first one, round one potential. That's just not consistent enough, and that's a little bit of a problem. Calvin Johnson, smaller, 6'2", 230, but he is mighty, and he's got a motor on him. He is scrapping people. He's really fast. He's a day three pick, but man, he kind of caught my eye. Mijai Sanders was solid. Tyreek Smith. Him and Trevor Penning were going at it all week. Day three pick, solid football player, but day three pick. And that's what I mean. Like, all these guys are really good, the edge guys at the Senior Bowl, and some of these tackles are going to go undrafted. And so, like, there's just a little bit of a mismatch. There's just a talent, physical mismatch. Zachary Carter is kind of a tweener at 290. He's got a good get-off. I worry about him playing inside, holding up with that smaller frame. But He's hard to deal with because he's a little bit twitched up for that big. Aaron Hansford, I don't think, played in the game. Didn't really hear much from him during the week. Brian Asamoah probably won the week from the linebacker standpoint. 33.5-inch arms is nuts. He's going to fly at the combine. He's a little bit undersized, but big-time JOK vibes from him. Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoah from Notre Dame put together a great rookie season for Cleveland. I don't have him over Dean or Lloyd. That being said, I think he's going to work himself into that conversation with Brandon Smith, Christian Harris, Chad Mama. Chad Mama, I think, was a little bit disappointing. Not necessarily horrible, but just didn't help his stock much. Channing Tindall, one of my guys. I mean, this dude flies in the game. In the game on special teams, he pretty much chased down Bo Melanin. He's got some freakishly speed. Didn't get a ton of snaps. That was kind of the thing we talked about in this film, is splitting time with Quay Walker. Didn't really play much the year before with Monte Rice, N'Kobe Dean, and Quay Walker. But, when you saw him, he started putting it together. He's going to be – I really like what he can do at the next level. Demone Clark did not play in the game. I don't even know – I didn't really hear anything. I didn't even know he was down there, to be quite honest with you. Darian Beavers, I heard, really impressed. I think he's got a safety background. Really good in coverage. He was good in coverage in the game. I have some notes. Good coverage, and I started it twice. Good at picking up running backs in the flat. He's I think he helped the stock. DeMarco Jackson probably just solidified it. I heard some good things. Probably day three pick. And Troy Henderson was good for Montana State. I heard his name mentioned a couple of times, making some tackles. And then Terrell Bernard, who's just he moves well. He's fast. And got some good instincts. He's just a little undersized. We'll see. He flashes, man, like that Ole Miss game. He was all over the place. I think he's a scheme guy. If you have a spot on the defense where you like him, because he's a playmaker. He is a playmaker along with his buddy Jalen Petrie, who we'll talk about in a second. Didn't hear much about Evans from Missouri. I don't think he played. Alante Taylor had a nice pick. He kind of got burned off the line of scrimmage, but some nice recovery speed and made a play on the ball. Cam Taylor Britt, I'm hearing safety rumors that he's doesn't quite have those physical traits of a cornerback, but he's big at 5'10", 200. He's a very good tackler. He's physical. I heard he could be moving to safety. Kobe Bryant, man, I saw in the film, this dude never really panicked with the ball in the air. He panicked once. End of half. I think it was Malik Willis just threw one up and he like just tackled Calvin Austin, where it's like you just didn't need to do that. So that was a little bit surprising. Like you didn't see that on the film at all. Damari Mathis, didn't hear much about him. Darian Kendrick, I didn't hear much about him, but I just watched this film. I just worry about the speed. 5'11", 200 pounds. He's physical. He's got good press, but like he doesn't have that short area quickness that you want. Gregory Jr., I did not hear anything from him. I think they mentioned the school, but I didn't hear much about him. And then Jalen Petrie, who not exactly sure where he's going to fit. I see him more as a safety. Surprised he's listed at cornerback. I think he can play in the nickel. I like him around the line of scrimmage. I get big-time Jamal Adams vibes from him. He's also, like I mentioned with Terrell Bernard, they're playmakers. They fly around the field. Jalen Watson, didn't hear much about. JoJo Domans, like, he's listed as a cornerback. He played, like, nickel for Nebraska. He's going to be, like, a weak side linebacker. I think he's more of a special team guy. He made a play on special teams. He's an interesting guy. I haven't gotten deep into his film yet, but 6'2", 226, and he was playing nickel, and he was holding up pretty good in the Big Ten. Josh Thompson, didn't hear much about him. Joshua Williams, didn't hear much about him. And then JT Woods, I didn't hear great things from what I heard. Kirby Joseph, I heard some good things about him. I didn't get to see him much in the game, but I heard some good things about him. And Leon O'Neal probably had one of the better weeks of practice. He won like the defensive back of the week. He comes up and tackles. I mean, 6'2", 11. He's physical. Worry about the range a little bit. We'll see what he runs, but he's a physical. I think he'll play box safety in the league. But he's physical, man. Mario Goodrich has been getting some, like, I've been hearing that he's being slept on. I haven't watched the film on him yet, so I can't really speak to that. Didn't really hear much about him in the Senior Bowl week. Roger McCrary, he lost. If there's a loser in the measurements, he lost it with those short arms. But I'm willing to look past it. I mean, he's one of the best cornerbacks in the SEC. The Iron Bowl film he put out, just man coverage with John Metchie that whole second half, played really well. I mean, John Metchie got him a few times, but he put out some impressive film. The ability to stick on guys, stick in their back pocket and be physical and competitive. I think he's a first-round guy, and we liked him. We liked him early. Sterling Weatherford, didn't hear much about. Tariq Carpenter, didn't hear much about. Tariq Castro-Fields, I heard GMs and scouts say that he caught their eye. I didn't see much of the wide receiver DB one-on-ones from him, but I heard he had a good week. Tariq Woolen has a funny story. Him and I believe it was Velus Jones were working on the one-on-ones, and Tariq Woolen on the first rep just eats him up. They didn't even get the ball thrown. It was a 1v1. They didn't even throw the ball. Velus Jones could not even get off the line of scrimmage. You see the frame, 6'3", 33-inch arms. Like, he pressed them and just Velus Jones couldn't get off. The next play, though, Velus Jones beats him pretty easily on an inside slant. So a little up and down from him, but the 6'3 with the 33-inch arms has to be enticing. Anderson from Toledo, I didn't hear much about. 33-inch arms, though. Long. Yusuf Corker's a box safety. I heard he just struggled in coverage. I don't think he helped himself. I mean, if you're a safety that can't cover that well, it's going to be tough. He passed off his zone coverage pretty poorly. That led to a Jake Ferguson touchdown, so not great. Zion McCollum, the FCS kid from Sam Houston State, did not look good. He got beat twice. One time it might have just been he slipped, and then another time he got beat. He seemed to struggle with just, like, the athletic ability of some of those Power 5 guys, and that does it. I mean, to wrap up, I think Perrion Winfrey had a phenomenal game. Looking at the box score, out of the quarterbacks, I'm probably picking Desmond Ridder as the winner. Kenny Pickett had a good week, obviously 6-6, 89 yards, and led his team to a touchdown. But then he's obviously the hand size is a question mark, and then it rained one day, and he struggled with that. I heard Desmond Ridder probably was the best out of that group, and then Carson Strong probably hurt himself the most out of that group. Out of the running backs, I think I'm probably giving the nod to Damian Pierce. I liked how he ran. I mean, the average doesn't show like how hard he runs. I was impressed with him. Rashad White and Abram Smith also are some honorable mentions. And then the wide receivers, I mean, this was tough because the offense just really struggled to throw. I'd probably give it to Jalen Tolbert, who I heard has some serious burners. Christian Watson too is a candidate. Christian Watson drew a PI and then has a 38-yard catch to come along with it. Polished 6'4" route runner with big hands and big arms. But I also heard really good things about Jalen Tolbert and Calvin Austin. To the defensive side of the ball, Brian Asamoah from the linebacker crew, Travis Jones, Perrion Winfrey from the D-tackle. And then edge, like a lot of edge guys had good weeks. Let's go check out the edge guys real quick. I'm trying to think of who really jumped out. Jermaine Johnson was in the 1v1s. I just wish he played in the game. I'll probably give it to either Boye Mafe just because he was so good in the game. I mean, this dude is really disruptive, and I did not have a good grade on him coming in. It was really good. And then out of the cornerbacks in the secondary, these guys weren't really tested that much, you know? Probably Leon O'Neal. He had some good tackles down in the box, came up and made some good plays. So I'd probably give it to him. So again, guys helped their stock out. Some guys hurt their stock, but it's a Senior Bowl, I think, is more for the smaller school guys to give them a shot to play against some top caliber guys. Trevor Penning held up a little bit, Max Mitchell not so much, and Travis Jones probably the biggest winner out of those non-Power 5 groups. Once again, thank you for rocking with the Rock Boys, and we'll be back later with more draft content. Peace.